next week, turn every hard and rocky heart into a fertile ground, so as they hear your word, it will grow and manifest in their actions. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'd like to thank the Almighty God for our lives this morning. Our text will take from three places. Exodus 33 verse 14. Deuteronomy 20 verse 4. Leviticus 26 verse 7. Exodus 33 verse 14 says, I will go with you and I will give you to you. Deuteronomy 20 verse 4 says, the Lord your God is going with you and he will give you to you. Leviticus 26 verse 7 says, you will be victorious over your enemies. What's the meaning of the word victorious? The word victorious means becoming triumphant. Imagine a winner. And who is a Christian? A Christian is a person who represents God and acts like him. A Christian is a person who represents Christ and acts like him. You ask yourself, who is a victor? A victor is a person who gains victory in all aspects of his or her life. To be a victor, it means before you get a problem, you already know that whatever problem comes your way, you overcome it through Christ. Even with the confidence that God loves you. No matter what, then you never leave me forsake you. Happy the assurance that you always fight for me. To live a life of victory is a present continuous tense. Without a contest, they can't be with you. And if you ever experience it, you know that when you make victory, there's a joy that comes with it. So when the Bible calls us victorious Christians, it means that we should be excited, happy, and joyful Christians. We shouldn't always wear the look of a defeated person. Because Christ came to conquer and close the truth. Life is a battle. And only those who fight in this battle will conquer. And to conquer, you need boldness. Jesus said, he's spoken the journeys of man. He came to conquer sin.
What trustworthy than what we see in the present time.
anything else you have hope that through all this tribulation there is more to the So let's always believe that there is just a few tunnel in our life. Just like you know the issue of blood. Our father Abraham, the father of
faith.
We have other examples in the Bible. I'm asking about faith is when you pray to God and you claim that you believe it, leave it to God. Don't worry about a prayer anymore. Just leave it to me. Because doing the tariff is not fair to
Christ.
Number three. Flee from sin. Flee from sin. Number three, flee from sin. Flee from sin.
Open and see the roof and the product that you want to put that off.
Sin is upstairs, surely bound to happen. As a Christian,
I don't want to say,
you try very hard not to sin. Because God placed the devil in the Bible, he was a serpent, so he worshiped and feed on dust, and keep man meat at the dust. So no matter how hard you try to run away from sin, surely comes to us. But it's up to you to resist the sin. That's why in James chapter 4 verse 7.
He
said to resist the devil and flee from us. That's to do your best to resist sin. As a child of God, you must be made victorious. You have to do every simple act. What are some examples of sin you have to do? Number one, sexual immorality. This one is most young people.
Leave
fornication. Number two,
theft.
Stealing from people. Taking what is not yours. Number three. You don't have any right to save anybody's life. Number four.
In India,
adultery. Looking for someone's wife, looking for someone's husband. Your spouse does not satisfy you anymore. Some people go to the length of giving their body just to get fruits. Leave people's husbands and wives alone.
That's it, I'm always for you.
Bye-bye. Read.
I'm meant for teaching.
Read.
Meant for teaching.
Wanting to have your own.
You see, you know, you know, you know, you know,
not want to give out.
The children are talking to one another, and I'm not going to be able to do
it. What is for yourself?
On top of what you're doing, you're not going
to be able to learn to do it.
Chapter 9 has fallen in and out of
the world. So that you receive the blessing from you.
I don't know what, but I'm not going to have no action.
Number 6.
And then,
malice.
I am a new one.
Malice.
I am a new one.
Keeping God against your neighbor.
I know I am a new one. I will move along.
If you are being used to ourselves here, someone can look into our hearts in the church.
You have to bring it to pay. I am a new one. I am a new one. I am a new one. I am a new one.
Every day, come and give offering to the Lord.
They say, I am a new one. I am a new one. I am a new one. I am a new one.
The Bible says that. The Bible says that if you are having a quarrel against your neighbor, you have a problem. Leave your offering before the altar and go and reconcile before you go and give it.
Let the Bible say now, Musa, for yet all covenant is that I'm the man, I love the king, and you will be the new one. You will have been there, Musa, and you will have been there. Why you never been there? I've been born with human action, and you will be the one. I've been a problem,
so please, today,
may the people be at all.
May you don't give your offering.
Make sure you're not
holding anybody at heart. Otherwise, your money is a waste. Number 7.
Adrenia.
Envy. Jealousy. Not wanting the good of your neighbor. You are forgetting that when the good thing comes to your neighbor, it also comes to you. You go and tell your sister's daughter on the tree. So that you will not get married until my daughter is married. But forgetting that when that person gets married,
maybe.
Forget that when that person gets married, you also benefit from the person's Anytime you see something, if you don't have enough of it, you go to red. Some of us have gluttony to food. Some of us have gluttony to food. We love eating a lot. We love eating a lot.
We
love eating a lot. Let's avoid returning to food and other things.
Then at the moment in our new other chocolate or new one was coming.
The next one is addiction. Addiction.
After we are like that.
Most of people are getting addicted to smoking and drinking.
And my daughter, I don't want them to back play your own.
For those that eat the cigarettes.
I know you know when I want to have a
flat it is for a reason.
There are no people that they will do that.
Because they made it because of their weather, they were the same for winter, the weather is cold, so they made it to be warm on the inside.
So in your work, you know, you know,
let's try to avoid this and infect
love.
What are the benefits of eating
the food?
Number 1. You have eternal joy. You'll be contented.
Yeah, you will ask for
you. Because you know that everything that you have and the capableness of God. You have peace. Peace of mind.
You
will sleep peacefully.
Yeah, I'm not ready. having nothing to worry about.
But through a
long,
eternal life.
When you
need a material life,
not
going to worry about, because in the end you are getting your reward. Wherever you go, people know that you are there.
Who's the other now? That's why you're here.
When you start working out for others, it's work out for you.
Yeah, ma, but the young man, I don't know.
Christ loves us.
The moment.
Christ loves us.
Yeah, who are you? I'm not going
to be. And he wants us to live a victorious life.
Yeah, what's all your back? And I'm not going to
be. So don't give up on him. Look at your neighbor and tell your neighbor, don't give up on God. You are still in God's plan. You are still in God's plan. Thank you. Just in Jesus' name.